New Orleans is one of the planet's unique cities, shaped by a diverse cultural history, rich in architectural gems, but perhaps best known for this. Here you'll find musicians on almost every corner, but many in the Big Easy, despite their obvious devotion and talent, live close to the poverty line.
We have to do what we have to do to survive, you know what I'm saying? And we have, and it be like a long day, and we barely make $40 to $50 a day on a daily basis.
But help is at hand, and it's exemplified by places like the Musician's Village. This community was built with artists like Edward Lee in mind. He owns a house here and has a safe and creative place to live.
You have different musicians from different genres of music that are in a limit of one block. It's amazing. I mean, we're always getting together and combining songs and putting new ideas and concepts together in this area.
Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Tight.
And on the other side of the city, the musicians' clinic treats more than 2,000 artists and their families. Doctors provide care for the estimated 4 out of 5 local musicians that don't have medical insurance. And co-founder Bethany Ewald Boltman says it's the only way to help people she considers cultural ambassadors of the city.
We have to give them the dignity and the esteem that what they're doing as musicians or Mardi Gras Indians is vital, and I think they deserve it.
Over the years, the birthplace of jazz has all too often become an early grave for the city's musicians. Buddy Bolden, one of the early pioneers of jazz, is buried in an unmarked plot somewhere in this pauper's graveyard. He was 29 when he died, and it's that kind of tragedy that New Orleans wants to avoid for generations to come. Because above all else, it's about preserving the soundtrack of a city. Andy Gallagher, New Orleans, Louisiana.